Hi, Nancy.
Hi.
Oh, dear, Nancy, you look terrible.
Oh, thanks, Jake. Very kind of you.
No, no, I mean you look unwell. Are you sick?
Yeah, I think I am. My head is all fuzzy. I'm feeling really warm.
It sounds like you have a fever. You shouldn't be at work.
It's fine. It's better that I'm here than doing a little bit, than being at home, doing nothing. I've so much to get done.
Not at all, Nancy. On the face of it, it might seem like we'd all prefer you here doing something. But really, it's better for everyone if you're resting at home.
How?
Well, for starters, if you have an infectious illness, you may contaminate the rest of us here.
Well, I don't want to do that.
No, and you're probably exacerbating your own illness by being here. You'll get better quicker if you're recovering restfully at home.
I know that, but I don't want to let down Nina, our boss. She expects me to complete all of my work.
Don't worry about Nina. She's a great boss. Other companies and bosses may have their head in the sand about presenteeism, but Nina treats her employees well.
Presenteeism?
Yeah. Presenteeism is habitually coming to work despite being unwell. It's the opposite of absenteeism, which is habitually failing to come to work.
I know about absenteeism. Surely absenteeism is worse than presenteeism.
Well, you might think so, but it really isn't. Unwell employees cost employers lots of money in medical expenses.
Oh.
And the level of performance of a sick employee is often in the gutter. Employers don't want their staff producing poor quality work.
That is true.
So, at this company, Nina looks after us. She tells us to stay at home when we're ill.
Oh.
Yeah, and it works. We have had such low turnover the last few years, and despite the difficult economic climate, we haven't had to downsize at all.
That's good. So, should I go home?
Yes. Go home and rest. I'll tell Nina.
Okay. Well, thanks, Jake.
You're welcome. I hope you feel better soon.